Hi guys, I'm Ram Agarwal. You are watching my channel 52 Pixels. Let's get started. Hi guys, in this tutorial, we are going to see how to retouch the color balance of the skin using Photoshop. So as you can see, this is the image that we are going to work with today. And in this particular image, as you can see, the color balance is not much balanced actually. So what I mean to say is that the skin is looking a little faded away. There's not a color information to the skin, and I don't know, it's just because of the light from behind that is just making this side of the face a little dark, brighter, and this one a little darker. So it doesn't look that good, and the skin is looking overexposed a little bit. So we are going to adjust that and retouch the skin using color balance, so that we can adjust the color of the skin and make it look even more natural and basically a realistic effect. So for that, what we are going to do is just go to select. Under select, we have something called as color range. So we might have already learned that to work with a particular part of an image, what we have to do is just make a selection. But instead of making a selection using the quick select tool or the lasso tool, we would prefer go to select and color range. And we have already seen that color range is used for sampling colors, or you know, like selecting a different shade or a color from the image so that we can work with this one. So yours might be probably set to somewhat just like this. So what you have to do is just go to this drop down over here, just switch it from sampled colors to skin tones. So it will just detect the skin tones and it will select those. Now here we have the option called as detect faces. So if we just check over here, in this particular case, as you can see, it is not working well. It's because of the improper color balance. It's not just working that well. So for that, this particular example, I'm just going to turn this off. So detect faces is not turned on right now. And fuzziness, it's around 61%. If you increase, more region is going to get selected. If you decrease, nothing will get selected. So just make sure that fuzziness is around that particular number which selects your skin properly, as well as the less background is selected. Even if some part of background is selected, it's not to worry. We can work with that later onwards. And if you want to see this grayscale screen preview over here, you can just tap over here with selection preview. Yours might be set to none. Just go to the drop down and select grayscale. So now once you are done with the selection, and once you're satisfied with the selection, you can just click on OK. As you can see, this region is not getting selected properly. It's because this is a bright region and we don't want to work with that as well. We just want to work with this darker region because we want to balance the colors and the shade. So now that this region and the whole image that we wanted to select is got selected, what we are going to do is go to adjustment. In adjustments, here we have the option called as color balance. The thumbnail looks like a balance, a beam balance. So it is the same thing. You just tap on that. You go to color balance. Here we have options for cyan, red, magenta, green, yellow, and blue. I just want to make this part of screen skin a little yellowish, a little warm. So I'll take this from blue towards the yellow side. Make sure you don't lose the subtleness of the image, because the image should be a little subtle. It shouldn't look edited or over like the warmth. Should be natural. It should look natural. It shouldn't look like the person is having jaundice or something. It's just for fun. But for like in real effect, if you want to edit the image that it looks real, it looks believable, make sure you don't mess up with the colors too much. Just small adjustment should work. And now that you have adjusted yellow to -12, you can adjust reds to around +12, just to adjust the yellowness of the image. So +10 is always good, or even +12 could work. So it's totally up to you and the image that you want to work with. So I've kept yellow as -12, red as +12. So as you can see, this is the before and this is the after. So as you can see, there's not much difference, but the little difference counts. And this difference looks better because the shades are balanced, the tone is balanced, and the overall image is looking quite natural and it's looking quite good. But as you can see, with this part of skin and with the face, even this part and some parts of the dress are getting colored as well, which we don't want. So for that, what we are going to do is just go to this selection. So to work with this selection, what we have to do is just press the Alt key and then tap on the thumbnail. So this mask selection is going to get displayed over here. So this is the preview for the mask selection. Now we are just going to use the black brush and just paint the unwanted regions. So I just want the skin. So apart from the skin, whichever region I have in the image, which is white, I'm just going to turn that black and just paint over it. So as you can see, you can use a bigger brush as well and just paint out the extra regions that we don't want. Make sure that you are precise with your painting, because if you just mess up with the paint, it's just going to hurt you a lot and it will just cost you more efforts. Instead of that, just be sure and sharp with your selection and the paintbrush. So as you can see, just as we wanted, I have selected the regions of skin that I wanted. The regions that I didn't want are not selected now. Now I can again, to go back to normal, I can just press Alt key and go to this thumbnail, and I've got back my original image. So now with this one, I can just turn this on and off. So as you can see, only the skin is getting affected. So this is before and this is after. Not much change, but even this small change looks better and it's just looking so appealing and natural, and moreover, it's believable. So well, that's it for today, guys. If you found the video to be helpful, please like the video, and in case of any queries or suggestions, please feel free to reach out to me through the comments. With that being said, it's me, Ram Agarwal, signing off for the day. See you in the next one. Thank you.